Hi everyone, it's Natasha. I wanted to share with you the Scrapalopes templates and formula that I used. And this is Scrapalope is actually something that Sarah, who is 3 dogs and 2 kids here on YouTube, had posted quite some time ago, I think maybe close to a year ago. But then she was playing on Ustream the other day, and I popped in to peek in to see what she was doing, and she was making more Scrapalopes, but they were a size that she was trying to fit a particular item in. So she had created that. And then I thought, well, why don't we come up with the sizes and the dimensions for some standard, you know, some standard sizes like the ATC size, an A2 card size, and a number 10 like policy envelope. So that's what I did. And then I had offered to create PDF files or just download image files. So I have the first one done, and it's the ATC one. And let me show you the two that I made. One, I made this one on a Ustream right after Sarah's, and I just used craft color paper. And this one I made the other day using different color rings as well as eyelets and different color ribbon. So you could totally make this as decorative as you want. You know, the whole utilitarian design, but a pretty format. And I even have a finishing. They're the like, reinforcers. Actually, you could probably use the Tim Holtz reinforcer stickers for this, for the inside, not for the outside, because then it would stick. So this also fits gift cards. Like, there's a Dunkin' Donuts gift card in this one, and I think this might have just regular ATC in it, or nothing. So the template is going to be available on my blog. Oh, sorry. I'll include a link in the description below. So here's some black ATCs, and there's 3 of them, and they all fit inside here. Obviously, you can fit one with a little bit of a dimension. So this has an eighth inch. About an eighth inch relief, I think, around the ATC, or maybe more. Yeah, just about. So the black lines are cut lines, and the blue perforated are the fold lines. So it's a 6 1/4 by 5 1/2 piece of paper. And then these are the score lines, the 2 score lines vertically, and the 2 score lines horizontally. Then you cut all 4 corners on the inside of the fold. So when you score, you want to cut on the inside, so when you're folding it, you don't have resistance on the side. So stop by my blog if you want to get the ATC one. As soon as I'm done with the other sizes, the A2 also only uses one sheet of 8.5 by 11 paper. And for these examples, it's really sturdy. I used the Hobby Lobby craft paper. So you can see it fits a regular standard A2 size card. And I did finish this one on the inside as well. It's just a little touch, you know. Those are the kind of things that are noticeable. But this one, you could totally send through the mail. All you need to do is, and I did use red line tape to adhere all of these so they're on nice and sturdy. All you need to do is put a little bit of a red line tape underneath that, and then you can post it through the mail like you would any other envelope. And this one, actually, because it's a number 10 size envelope, fits inside this. So in order to add the little bit of a relief of an eighth of an inch, one sheet of paper wouldn't do it, so I just added a 2-inch strip down the front. So there's a seam right down the middle from the craft paper. Let me see if you could see it from the inside. See if it's a number 10 size envelope. Oh, my work. You see the little black line down the center? That's how much of a gap it would have produced because I added the eighth of an inch. If you want to make it smaller, it would just meet up. So I decided to add this piece of a 2-inch strip of different color paper. And the variations, you can, you know, you can put patterned paper down the strip middle. So you can make these, once you have the formula, I'll also include the formula if you have non-standard sizes. Essentially, it's finding your item that you're trying to create the envelope for, placing it, adding an eighth of a relief or more. You can add a quarter inch of a relief on all sides. Make sure you don't forget about the top and bottom. If you have a dimensional item like a card or something that is a some kind of memorabilia you want to create an envelope for, you could totally do it. And then you need to double up on the size of the flaps plus half an inch. And you can, make the variation wherever you need to. But I'll have all the descriptions on my blog. So I'm finally doing this video because I finally have the ATC template done. So that will be posted on the blog as well. And that includes the hole locations. I don't know if you could see them. They're very, very faint. And the reason I left them faint is for those of you who want to use this to print out on your pattern paper or color paper. You could do that because these would fold on the inside and the black lines would cut away. So then you won't be left with anything. Or you could print this off on the sturdiest paper you have and then cut it out and keep it as a template to use on pattern paper that you can't run through the printer. There's a couple of different options. If you have any questions for me, please leave me a comment. If you want to see how to put one together, I'll include a link to Sarah's video where she creates the scrapalope originally, including all the binding information and, how to place the, the eyelets and all that. And again, if you have any questions for me or for Sarah, I'll leave a comment. Thanks for watching, everyone.